Hi guys, this is Saurabh. In this video, I'm going to explain you about MIT App Inventor. So here's some points of this video. So first point, what is MIT App Inventor? Second, login into MIT App Inventor. Then explain some options of MIT App Inventor. Four, create very simple app. So here we go. First, open your browser and type here MIT App Inventor. And you will see this option MIT App Inventor website. And here you will see the option of this button create apps. Click on this. Now you will see here the option for sign in. So I'm going to sign in using Google account. Right, and here they will ask for some term of services. Read it carefully and I accept the term of service. Simple. Now here we are. That's our dashboard. Continue. And here's some basic examples. So I'm going to close this. Right, and here you can see there's a lot of options here, like projects. So the option of my projects, start new project, import file and export file, import from repository. So .aia is the extension of your MIT App Inventor app. So whenever you try to import some app from another source, so you have to import .aia file. And here is the option of connect AI campaign emulator USB to test your app. Right, and the third one is build, so you can create your app APK, and there is a setting option and there is a help option. So first we are going to create here simple app. So here you need to click on start new project, and your app name is I'm going to just image display. And here you are not going to, here you cannot use the space in your app. Okay, so click on OK. Now this will take some seconds to open your dashboard. That's so here is our app screen here now. So here is a lot of options so you can use, and here you can add a screen also. So in this app we are going to use only one screen here. And now we are going to use here a lot of option here: user interface, layout, media, drawing, animation, map, sensor and storage also. So we will learn one by one. So first we are going to use here layout. So first thing we are going to use here vertical scroll arrangement or vertical arrangement. So vertical arrangement is good for us for right now. And this height should be fill parent, and width is also full parent, like that. Now we need to use here one button like this, and the second one is image like this. So here's option, you can align top, so I'm going to use center, and alignment is also center like this. And I'm going to use here some pictures, so click on image, and here you have to click on none option picture, upload file, and upload one file from your desktop. And I'm going to use your Mario PNG. Okay, great. So it's uploaded. Now height should be fill parent, and width is also fill parent. So it look like this. Right, great. So click on your button, and I'm going to rename this button. So this app should be something magic, and click on OK, and our button name is magic, and display something is also magic. And here we just do some design in our button. So font size should be something 20, and background color something. You can custom, you can use either custom color also. So I'm going to use this one, and my text color should be white, for right now. And here's the option of save. So I'm going to use a rounded button, and this one is fine, and height and width. So if I'm going to use it, fill parent is not a good option. Okay, no, it's not looking really good. So I'm going to use your percentage. So I'm going to use it 10. This one is good, pretty good, right? So I'm going to hide this image, and whenever I click on this button, so this image will show. All right, so I'm going to visible off, click on this, and like here you can see there's nothing in this, and you have to just press inventory button. So I have to write some code in my block section. So here is the design section, and that one is block section. So click on block, that's one, and now click on this magic, that's our button name. So when magic dot click, okay, so drag and drop this, then image, so set image picture to, so just drag and drop, so it should be visible. So you can use their option is of, there's one option already, option is set image visible to true. So I'm going to remove this. You can remove from here and set this and type here true. No, true, fine. So like this, and fine. So whenever someone click on your button, so image will be displayed in your screen. Okay, so that's very simple app. So I'm going to test this app on my mobile phone. So here you can see that option, that app MIT AI 2 campaign. So you have to install this app in your mobile phone, in your Android. So I'm going to install this. Okay, that's my mobile phone. I'm going to install this on my mobile. Seconds and minutes to install device soon. Okay, fine, install. So now I'm going to test this. So here's the option of connection. So click on AI campaign and open your app. Open your app. So open your app. So here you can see, you can search MIT App Inventor AI 2 campaign, and now continue without Wi-Fi. No, using Wi-Fi here to find. I'm using here Wi-Fi. Now scan QR code. Click on scan QR code. Then here this code. Simply, and wait for some seconds. This will scan your. This app will show in our mobile screen. So here you can see that's our app. So whenever I'm click on this button, you will see that image is here. So that's very simple app to create. Okay, that's the starting point of MIT App Inventor we are going to use here. So make this app as an EPK file. So here is option of click on build and save .apk to your computer first thing, and then click on this. And you can install this app. You can transfer this app APK from your desktop to your mobile and install this app. Otherwise, you can use second option to scan QR code from your mobile and download APK directly to your phone. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me on comment. In the next chapter, we will learn how to change the icon of your app and do some settings and learn more component and do more in MIT App Inventor. So thank you so much for watching this video. Please like my video and subscribe my channel for more updates. Thank you.